countries have to focus on their own priorities. Of course, they also need to focus together of the common interests, for example, vaccines, saving lives, things like that. So at this critical moment, what are some of the sensors you have regarding Europe as a whole or some of the economies on the European continent? How do they look at their relationship across the Atlantic and also their own blueprint for the future?
The relationship, despite the perceived unity of the European Union, the problem is that the European Union has really no legal standing to do foreign policy. So despite you see trade, of course, is done at EU level, but foreign policy is not. And so foreign policy falls back into the responsibilities of individual member states.
Yes.
And therefore, everyone does what they think is right. You know, the UK may have a special relationship, so with Germany, so with Italy. We do all have a good relationship with the United States, but then the terms of engagement are very different. I've been dealing a lot with the relationship between Italy and China. I did, of course, look at the relationship between Brussels and China, but clearly the most effective way to deal, negotiate, and establish relationship is a bilateral, not at the regional level. Because Chinese policymakers and government, if I may, yes, they do look at Brussels when it comes to trade, the tariffs, but when it comes to the foreign relationship, the foreign policy relationship, personal relationship, they do go to individual countries, as they should. So